When I turned 50, I got my nursing license. I said Hawaii, and Tito said, let's go. So we flew to Maui, went to Makawao, got a bike. There was a street fair. We met some cool people, ate cool food. It was a party, so vacation started. We met this guy. He's an Elvis impersonator, and his dog is the baby Jesus.
The baby Jesus.
Met this guy. His name is Nui Nui. His dog's name is Rainbow and lives in that bag. I danced with Nui Nui. He explained that he is a fleur, and since I know that means flower, I didn't ask him any more questions. This is Christine Corey, and she's in the band. She gave everybody a swing dance lesson. We were just off the plane, but we took the lesson. And then Tito had a very serious dance partner. After that, it was time to find our B&B and call it a night. We made the drive to the summit of Haleakala National Park. It is a volcano where lots of people go every day to see the sun rise over the crater. A great spot to take pictures. This was well worth the trip. Contrary to TripAdvisor reports, we saw no traffic going up to the summit. It is cold, so bring the right gear. Do rent a bike. They make it very safe for people to descend the volcano, which is exactly what Tito did, and he said it was great. I decided to hike, and plank, and do yoga. Jump, 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 jump.
We covered a lot of ground right away.
Eat, sleep, eat, and whale watching right away, because that's how we roll. The boat ride was fun. It was really windy. Hawaii is using wind, as you can see from these turbines. It was wavy on our way out to Molokai, where we would eventually go snorkeling. The crew served breakfast and coffee, and even had to help some people back to their seats because it was a little choppy. Tito got a great spot to take some pictures. This time, instead of on top of the volcano, he's taking it from sea level, snapping away, and just perfect. Meet Morgan. She's on the crew, has a master's in biology, and was able to tell us about the sea life. Hello, coffee. I really enjoy snorkeling once I stop panicking a little bit. It just takes my breath away. It's so beautiful. Tito has the camera. He's here looking at fish, and the fish are looking at all of us. There are a bunch of us in the water, but it never seems crowded. That's me. That trip took all day. We said goodbye to the ocean and went back up to Kula, where we were staying. Snapped a few of the sunset. Said ooh and ah a couple times. Called it a night. I woke up to this on my birthday in the art space. And that was followed by pancakes and more singing. We took the famous road to Hana, where it's all about the journey. Of course, it's all about the winds and twists and surprises and many stops. Here's a blowhole. The red post has a sign that says, don't stand here. But that's where we were standing, because that's the best place to see the blowhole. And it was my birthday. And so we just stood there and watched it until Tito's cameras got wet and he got wet and we decided to move. They say the road to Hana is all about the journey, but I think it's about the blowhole.
Whoa! Whoa!
See what I mean? And the waterfalls. This is Ohio Gulch, about 1,000 feet and falling. Definitely worth the stop. It's also about great hiking partners.
Here, stand up, I'll take a picture.
Here's Tito coming back from where he's not supposed to be because there was a sign that said don't go here. But we're about ready to find out what we missed from over there. So what was over there, Tito? This is being documented.
There's not much water over there right now.
Really?
Uh-uh. Just massive amounts of boulders and pool.
Okay. Alright, so onward ho.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all about the journey, but here's the destination. This is Hana. Please do not sit or lean. Please do not sit or lean. Please do not sit or... Never mind. We had to make a quick getaway, so we took this tiny plane. Goodbye, Maui. Hello, Molokai. A strong stomach is helpful when driving from one end of the island to the other. In case of not a strong stomach, sucking on ginger candy really helps too. It did. Anything for a good picture.
So we just arrived at the trailhead of Kalapapa, and according to the directions, we're supposed to go right here where it says posted no trespassing. And that's exactly where we're supposed to walk. Oh yeah, that's the signal that the party's about to begin. Here we go. It says no trespassing, but we're going down this Jeep trail. And we'll see you along the way. Well, we made it to the tour meetup spot at the bottom of Kalapapa in less than an hour and a half. There are just three little pickup trucks down here. It was really just like walking down a lot of stairs. It was not bad at all if you like walking down a lot of stairs for about an hour and a half.
Formerly known as a leper colony, Kalapapa is the place where people were sent if they were even thought to have leprosy or Hansen's disease, and many didn't. A simple spot on your skin could get you banished to Kalapapa for life. Fear of the disease, and no cure, posed a certain stigma. Belgian priest Father Damien is famous for forming community in Kalapapa. He wasn't afraid of the sick. He cut these holes in the floor so that people with leprosy could let their secretions fall into the holes and still they could attend service. Thousands died here, including Father Damien, who contracted the disease. Today, there are still people who live in Kalapapa. They survived Hansen's disease, and they chose to stay in Kalapapa because they had formed family and community there with the help of Father Damien and others who came to serve. This bookstore exists in Kalapapa to dispel many of the myths out there about the place and the people. There is a lot of fiction about the place, but Kalapapa's collective stories let the truth remain. It was this spot where boats would come and bring patients. People were ripped away from their families, sometimes very young children. They didn't know the course of their disease. They knew there was no cure. But they didn't know where they were going or who they'd be with. It was frightening. It's also not a very hospitable place to land. You can see the rocks, and when it's rough, there's no certain way to get ashore. There is a cure for this disease. That's good. But standing at this spot, thinking about the thousands of people who came here fearful, evokes a reverent mood among all who visit. While the stories elicit tears, being there made me wonder about ethics and public health and how some questions don't have really good answers. Tito reflected upon his visit there 37 years ago, and he even found the same rock, though it's been repainted, and it really shows the winning spirit among the people who were just castaways here. Going up and out of Kalapapa took even less time than descending the cliff. We went back to our place on the unbelievably beautiful beach to reflect. We met with Amelia Nordic from Sustainable Molokai to get a pulse on the island. They've done an extensive energy assessment, have a food hub, and educational programs. With so many beautiful beaches, we just didn't sit on them very much. There was so much more to do in Hawaii. I didn't want to leave, so I climbed this tree, basically refusing to leave. I'd like to return to see the nice people of Hawaii again, with my travel partner. So, aloha and mahalo for now. On a white sandy beach of Hawaii, the sound of the ocean soothes my restless soul. Sound of the ocean rocks me all night long. Those hot, long summer days, lying there.